This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, here's our next uniform motion problem, rate time distance problem. John and Maria are 345 miles apart. At the same time, they leave driving toward each other. John's average speed is 15 miles per hour faster than Maria's, and they meet after 3 hours. How far does each drive before they meet? All right, so here's the picture. And by the way, feel free to put the video on pause and try it on your own first. So we've got John and Maria. Miles apart. And they start driving toward each other, and John's going faster. So they're going to meet somewhere closer to where Maria started. Okay. That's all we know so far because we don't know the distance yet. In fact, that's exactly what we're trying to find. So let's make up a little chart, rate times time equals distance chart. So we've got John and Maria. We don't know their rate, but we do know that they both have the same amount of time if we look here. Right, so what do we know about their rate? John's speed, okay, speed means rate. It's 15 miles per hour faster than Maria, so he's going faster than Maria. So how about letting Maria be X, that's her rate, so then John's rate will be 15 more than that, X plus 15. Right, what do we know about their time? They leave at the same time. They meet after 3 hours. So they are both traveling for a total of 3 hours. And we know once you have something for their rate and their time, their rate times time equals the distance. So John's distance will be x plus 15 times 3. Now remember, that's a whole quantity, like it's in parentheses, so it's really 3 times x plus 15. And Maria's is easier, it's just x times 3, so we could just put 3x. Now let's go ahead and simplify John's distance. We're going to do the distributive property, 3 times x plus 3 times 15. So John's distance, 3x plus 45, is what I could put up here. That's the representation of that distance. So this is 3x plus 45, that's John's distance, and Maria's distance over here is 3x. So by the picture, his distance plus her distance is that total distance they were apart from each other. So that's the equation we can get by looking at that picture. So we've got John's distance, 3x plus 45, plus Maria's distance, which is 3x, adds up to a total of 345 miles. All right, so I'm going to add the like terms, and at the same time, how about just subtracting 45 from both sides? So we have the variables on the left. We've got 6x equals 300, and dividing both sides by 6, we get x equals 50. Okay, so now we have to remember, what did x stand for? Well, we look in this chart where we defined x right here. That was Maria's rate. And by the way, if you look at the question, it didn't ask for her rate. It says, how far does each drive before they meet? But in order to get that, we're going to need to know her rate. So looks like her rate's 50. All right, so what we're going to do is take this chart we have, and we're going to check and make sure everything in there makes sense. So we had John, we had Maria, we had their rate, which now we're going to be able to put in the actual number, their time, and their distance. Again, rate times time is going to equal distance. All right, so now that I know what x is, I could put that in for Maria's rate. That's 50. And John's rate was 15 miles per hour more, which is 50 plus 15, which is 65. We already knew their time. So to get John's distance, we'll just do 65 times 3. So that's 195. And we have to do 50 times 3 to get Maria's. All right, so it looks like he traveled 195 miles and she traveled 150 miles. Let's see if that makes sense with our picture we had. We had John and Maria, and we're now saying John actually went 195 miles and she went 150 miles. And what did we know at the beginning? How far apart were they? They were 345 miles apart. Okay, does that make sense? With this scenario, does that mean that they were at 345 miles apart? Is 195 plus 150? Does that add up to 345? And yes, it does. So now we have to answer the question. Back up to the question here. How far does each drive before they meet? Okay, that means their distance, right? So now we could look at this chart and we see John's distance was 195 and Maria's was 150 miles. So we say John drove 195 miles and Maria drove 150 miles. And that is our answer. We checked it all checked out. It made sense. So you might try this on your own. And then if you need help, you could just always look back. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.